Sup, Trophy Hunters, King Superwines just signed in, and welcome to What Games That I Actually Cheated On, or What Games That I Hacked, more like using the game saves instead of hacking. And since now people decide to watch my videos and not watch any of the past videos, like I already explained this, but I guess I'm gonna have to do it again and hopefully never deal with this bullshit again. So let's talk about the first game. So here's the first game I did. Let me explain how this happened. There was a YouTube video on getting majority of the trophies on Red Faction Guerrilla, and it had instructions on how to put the save on the PS3 through the PC. And that's basically what I did. Messed around playing Red Faction single player and ended up getting Power to the People through Insurgent, as you can tell. But then I saw something else which made me go to the second game. So here's the second game that possibly nobody's going to attempt to play unless you really love the repetitive of this bullshit game. So let me explain this. I played the game legit and beaten the game, but then as soon as I played on ultra hard difficulty, fuck this game. I did not want to play this shit anymore, so when I found out there was a website of certain games you can game save, I wanted to get rid of this crappy game as soon as possible and never deal with it again. But obviously, I was wrong to do this. So most likely, from Crossroad Blitz to the Platinum is all the ones I basically cheated on. But sadly, there's a third game to this nonsense. So here's the third game that I'm not happy on game saving. This is my favorite Battlefield, and maybe the only reason why I'm into Battlefield now. But getting action, not words, to On Top of the World, I feel like I'm missing out on an awesome single player game. Into fuck this game, I don't want to deal with this shit. And I really, of course, did not want to overdo this, as I really want to play it legit regardless. And I'm not proud of doing this. But sadly, there's one more game. Here's the fourth game. Obviously, the first trophy isn't even possible, but this game, I'd rather play the first one than the second one anyways. I realized after I attained 9 irony, I told myself, what's the point of this? Why am I effortlessly getting trophies without putting work on it? When Wet crossed the line, it made me feel different on playing the game to achieve your goal into doing some technical bullshit just to pop a trophy and move on. But also, sometimes there are exploits into getting certain trophies without game save cheating. Like this next game. Let me explain how this happened from Piercing Void to Flail Master on Ninja Gaiden Sigma 2. When I played the game, I downloaded some of the campaign videos to watch. Then I quit the game to delete the install and patch. Then restart the game to play, but I had to wait for the install first. Then started to watch all of the videos until I was done. Then trophies started to pop up. That's how it happened. So yes, I didn't do any effort to this, but it's still an exploit to do. Any opportunity is always an opportunity. So this is legit. So there you go. 5 games I just explained. 4 are unacceptable and 1 is still okay. No, I'm not proud of popping those trophies without effort, and I refuse to hide them, so there's no need to hide my mistakes. I'm just gonna brush it off and move on. But I can already tell that things may change after this. But regardless, I'm still 100% legit, and you can argue at me over this nonsense, but I'm still the greatest trophy hunter. I mean, look at my ultra rare plats. Can't you see that I actually put time on these games? So let's explain the first game, Free Realms. Okay, I did that shit in 1 fucking month. Everything was fucking free for this description. That shit was fucking devastating as fuck. I think Free Realms is probably the one reason why I stopped trophying for a while. That game was too much. Like, holy fucking shit. Like, all that fucking work I have to do for that game. God damn it. Like, Battle Fantasia. Literally just like 3 trophies I can think of that are really, really hard. And that's basically it. Other than that, like, it's not even that bad of a game. Like, fucking Mortal Kombat DC Universe, like, fucking combos for fuck's sakes. That's all you need. That's all you need to know. Like, all that fucking work I did for that, like, god damn it, dude. Call of Duty Black Ops 2. The only thing I can think of is the RTS, but that's basically it. Quantum Theory, like, fuck, for fuck's sakes. Immortal, and fucking playing hard mode, like, oh my god, dude. Sonic All-Star Race Chance 4, like, come on. I did 2 fucking Sonic Racing games, and that game is fucking hard. Literally. Like, you can't auto-pop this. I did them both legit. Like, come on. Like, it's not that bad enough for you? Like, look, come on, look. King of Fighters 12, like, for fuck's sakes. Like, holy shit. 1,200 online matches. Like, why? Why? And then not only that, you had to fucking pick every single character and beat every single character with every single character. Like, what the fuck is that? Oh my fucking god. Like, okay, let me explain about Resistance 2. And it was really, really tough for me to think about because I did not want to play Resistance 2 again, even though I really, really had fun with it. And it was just something I cannot sit down and dedicate my life to. And that's basically what Resistance 2 was about to be, because I was like, I'm not really going to sit down and play hours on this again and then do all the co-op stuff. And then, like, damn, man, like, it was just like, I think about all the hard work I had to put on it, like playing Superhuman and all that, man. I probably should have done it, but at the same time, it's like, it's whatever, man. I didn't care. It's like, I wanted to just make videos and just try to do it whenever I can for everybody. But anyways, like, Wolfenstein, oh my god, like, the multiplayer in general, like, fuck that, man. Like, all that fucking work I gotta put on that. Sonic on fucking Unleash. Like, Sonic Unleash. Come on. It's already, like, you already, like, some people already know how fucking bad the game is. Like, holy shit. Dead Rising 2. Like, come on, 1,000 playthroughs and then fucking drive fucking zombie, drive around with a fucking car, killing everything. Like, god, I hate that shit. Killzone 2, I mean, come on, it's already, we already know. The ribbons are a fucking bitch. The fucking Valor Grand Falls was a bitch. Actually, I had to boost that one. The ribbons, that was a bitch to do, legit. And then fucking Radek was a different story. Like, holy shit, never in my life when I was on the fucking checkpoint for a fucking days. Like, god damn, dude. Little Bit Planet Card, I don't even know how the fuck is this ultra rare. How? Like, there's nothing serious about it other than the online trophies, and that's it. Oh, and the fucking traffic. That traffic thing. I need to figure out what that was called. But, Soul Calibur 5. I mean, literally, online, fucking the quick battles, bullshit. And there was, like, one trophy we had to play, like, legendary, and holy shit. God damn it. Like, holy fuck, dude. Fuck Soul Calibur 5. God damn it. Medal of Honor. Like, literally, Fire Control is the only thing I can think of for this game. And that's it. Everything else is simple. I mean, Tier 1, Veil of the Beast, that's it. Everything else, like, I don't know how the fuck is even wet ultra rare. Like, fuck that game, man. Like, Marvel Ultimate Alliance, I mean, what? There's, like, nothing serious about it. Nothing I can think that's hard other than the simulators, and that's it. Black Ops. I think Sacrificial Lamb is probably the only thing I could think of for this. Maybe Sacrificial Lamb. What else? Veteran's not even that bad. Yeah, that's basically it. I think it's a Sacrificial Lamb. Maybe the zombie trophies. That's probably it. Singularity, I mean, other than the online, nothing. Just online. Alien Call of Marines. Online and fucking Raven. And what else? Oh, the Single Service Medal. Well, that's basically online. I guess Ultimate Badass. But it's not that bad. I mean, if you co-op that shit, it's easy. I don't know, man, but that's the easy get. One for three. How the fuck is this ultra rare? Is there anything I can think of that was hard? Maybe Special Ops, because you can't do it by yourself, but that's it. That's the only thing I can think of. Create. What the fuck? The fuck out of here. Probably because, do people play this even if the server's shut? Like, how the fuck is it? Why is Create there? Like, I don't even know. But that's like, nobody even know what the fuck that is. That's how you know I put so much work into these games. Like, come on. Mind fucking jack. I don't know how the fuck this ultra rare, but okay. Like, maybe it could be, I guess the online, but that's it. Like, come on. All this work I did for all these ultra rares, man. That's all I got to say about this shit. Like, seriously. And I have more to get around the corner. But anyways, I'm done with this ranting bullshit. You can say what you want about me. You can comment what games you think I cheated on, and I guess I'll try to remember to answer them. And I'm still legit, so fuck you, and stay tuned for the next video as you're listening to the best fucking legit trophy hunter fucking ever. Fucking ever. experience.